year. So every, you can say the day to day, whatever lifestyle is from morning to late night, evening, digital technology, it is getting more and more each and every people, each and every institutions, whether they are government institutions or private bodies or private companies, or even different kind of social activities. Social activities means celebration of any kind of festival or any kind of political activities. So everywhere, entire India, it is going to be digitalized, and very soon 101% it will be digitalized in coming year. So whatever you subject you have chooses, that digitalization in India or scope of digital services industry in India, it is really very excellent type of the topic. Now you can ask your question, what exactly you want to know. Okay. Right. Okay. See, all of us try to understand the segmentation of India, especially in terms of digital into the business. In India or in any country, 2-3 different type of the segment we can divide. For example, government institutions, of course, business are also there. Second, it is the private company, whether they are big MNCs or small. Third, it is the individual. Individual means likewise me or any other body, whatever they are using digital services in their day-to-day life. In these three parameters, we will be discussing the scope of entire industry. The second important thing, who are the important player? Of course, for providing digital services, there are two important, you can say, the player. One who is providing the services. Likewise, in this categories, those come are professionals used to come, those who are directly providing the services on demand, that how to digitalize your company or yourself or your day-to-day activities. In this segment, again, you will say, starting from big foreign companies, big Indian companies, as well as the very small type of the company owners, or you can say the freelancers, or you can say the small companies or consultants, they are there. As you know that, Definitely right. Because of, see, the nature of Indian market, it is very much diversified. If you see the topo geographical condition of India, big players are there, big business houses are there, as well as medium size or very small or startup type of the business houses is also there, as well as the biggest market, or you can say the revenue comes from the uses of individual person, likewise me or any other person. For my day-to-day life, I am also using digital services by mobile, by internet, everything, whatever medium it may be possible. So person who are individually using, that is the unorganized. Typically you can divide organized market segment of organized sector, and next you can divide it into unorganized type of the sector. Likewise, on random basis, 1.2 billion people is there. If you assume approximately 60% are using internet as well as the mobile and all these things, so they are paying very less. But overall, the business size is very huge, and big companies in their respective field, they are trying to capture all these markets. Now, we are coming that what are the scope, from where you can generate the business. We should try to understand this thing first, that who are asking or who are demanding for all these segments, services. Typically, we can divide government. First, we will be discussing on government. You know, India, the political system or governance system of India, one central government, it is there. They are having their different kind of departments, employees, and different kind of services they are providing. The second different nature of government, it is there, that is the state level government. India is a union territory, you can say the 28 states, more than 28 states are there, likewise Uttar Pradesh, Delhi, Maharashtra. So every state in itself, they are having their own government. After that, within this government system, different kind of government departments are there. You can say electricity department is there, road construction department is there, public works PWD department is there, defense department is there, so many departments are there. So all these segments are right now on track. This is the clear cut instruction of each and every government. They are trying hard in very speedy manner changed their entire work. Whatever, however they were going to do work in past, file was going to maintain, manual work was there with pen and paper, files and all these things. Now everything is going to be transformed on digital platforms. In every department, everyone is using laptop, a particular, you can say, the software of that department, that ministry, website is there, each and every activity, record keeping, everything, it is going to be work only on digital service platform. This is one thing. Second thing, in past, if you see, whatever the files, whatever the government work was on papers, manual work, everything it is going to be digitalized in this manner, that government is giving order means to different kind of vendor, they are selecting vendor one who can digitalize their all old documents, right? So you can understand how many documents are there, especially particularly in government sector, and every document is going to be transferred by means of scanning, then arranging all these into the shape of file, and again all these vendors are going to hand over it to the government, and they are keeping it into digital locker. One very good initiative of Government of India is especially for digital services, launching of digital locker. Digital locker in the sense, Government of India will provide to its officers, department, government service, public, to utilize a locker as a digital locker in which you can keep your all documents, necessary information safe. So you can assume that in coming days, everyone will be using all these digital locker, digital services. Now coming on the next segment, that is the private sector. In private sector, here we will be talking only and only for the private companies. Take example, this is my own experience. When we started 20 years back our career, internet, it was very much limited. There was no mobile phone. Approximately in 1999 or 2000, mobile phone uses was formally launched or become popular in India. At that time, in private segment, in private company, the nature of work on day-to-day basis, how people were working. Again, pen and paper was there. Everything was going to be done on pen and paper. Right now, if you come to any Indian company, whether they are big company, MNC or small, automated entire software is there. Everyone is using SAP or their internally developed software is there. Even attendance and small things, leaves, attendance as well as approval of your travel allowances, everything, it has been automated. Everyone is put attendance digitally by means of thumb impression, and all these informations and data, it is supposed to be collected and maintained on a dedicated server of particular that company. So you can imagine, within 5 to 10 years, we will find that there will be no scope for manual work. Even if a government organization, previous there was a system that if you want to launch any FIR in police department or in any security, or if you have to give any kind of the complaint, everything it was manual. Right now everything it is online. Online options are there. Even you do not require to make a phone call. Even if you are making a phone call, then again it comes digital services, because of at receiver end one call center is there, and everything it is recorded and maintained in a digital file, that how many calls we got, what was the nature of complaint. So this was all about the private sector. Now coming the third vertical of this market, that is the individual uses. You know, as government, as private industries, they are going to change, they are coming on the platform, then whatever, everybody it is a consumer. So they are also forced or motivated to join this digital mission, whatever it has been started by Government of India. So in a day-to-day activity, even communication, it is through digital. It may be the video recording, video telecalling, telephone, phone calling, or you can say the WhatsApp, messaging, email, whatever you can say the tools and technique, it is available, because of every, if you go for in most of India, everyone is having, you can say, a smartphone on day-to-day. See, what is the nature of consumer behavior, especially for Indian? They are very much sticky for the, you can say, the smartphone uses, mobile and internet. Most of the time, either they are watching any kind of video or any kind of new event, if it is happening or happened across world or across India, they are sharing it. So everybody is going to get involved, or you can say everybody is going to sink into the ocean of digital India. So you can imagine how India is going to be activate on digital platform. Any question for this? Yeah. Right. Right. Right, I am going to tell you the figure about the, you can say, the geographical segmentation of Indian market. Approximately 28 states are there, as I have already told. In all these 28 states, approximately 530 districts are there. In all these 530 districts, there are approximately 7,000 towns. Okay, and in all these 7,000 towns, approximately 6 lakhs. Okay, I am again going to tell you. India is divided into 28 states. All these 28 states. In all these 28 states, approximately 530 districts are there. And in all these 530 districts, approximately 7,000 towns are there. And in all these 7,000 towns, or you can say in entire India, approximately 6 lakhs villages are there. 6 lakhs. How much? 6 lakhs. And all these towns, or you can exclusively, if you consider this figure, 6 lakh villages. So in India, rural market is going to be considered, which includes 6 lakh villages. Approximately 65 to 70% people still they are living in villages. Now I am going to tell you ground level fact of villages, development in the villages. Everybody in villages, they are also having the smartphone. Everybody in villages, they are having a dish TV, TV, all these things. For availing the digital services, whatever equipment, tools and technique it is required. Right now, everybody is well equipped in rural area. Now, whatever you told, it is 101% right. For even for the big MNCs, it is very important and typical task how to penetrate the rural area. And this is also a main task of Government of India. That digitalization of or efforts of Indian government should reach to each and every village. Government is also taking the first problem for private company. You know, whenever you are trying to penetrate rural area, should I continue? Okay. What challenges practically a big MNC or any company face? Whenever you move outside from metro or good city to, you can say, the rural area, the cost of your company cost or per activity cost, it increases. Now return or revenue generation, it may take little bit time because of nature of metropolitan consumer as well as the rural area consumer, it is totally different in terms of their, you can say, the capacity to purchase or capacity to spend based on per day or per month basis. So developing infrastructure for digitalization, likewise telephone or mobile tower may be required, or landline it may be required, optical fiber landline development it is required. So cost become very much high. So this is the first basic challenge for any kind of MNC or any kind of the company. Now the second important thing is there, that of course due to certain reason metropolitan consumer, they digitalization or using the digital services, it is their day-to-day need. But educating to the rural consumers, especially for full use of any kind of digital services, it is also another important task. But fruitfully, or you can say, it is a good sign that especially using the digital services even by rural consumers, it is not a typical problem. Because of today's translation or website, or every company, they are having their website in local language, in English as well as in Hindi also. So that's why every rural area consumer, they are also frequently using all kind of digital services, whether browsing the website, browsing different kind of getting information, different kind of movies, videos, WhatsApp, everyone is using. So these are only the major problem for penetration of rural area. It is developing the digital infrastructure in rural area, and Government of India, along with the private companies, along with all vendors, they are trying very fast. That's why just few months back, earlier to this, we were hardly, you can say, using 2G and 3G. Right now, everyone, or you can say the most of the consumer, Jio, it is the Reliance Group company, they have launched 4G services. Now, Government of India as well as the private company, they are also trying to improve the speed of providing the digital services. From 3G, it will go to the 4G. Because of India is hungry, India is having a very great thirst only and only for the, you can say, the digital services. Right. Yeah, 101%. See, you see, it is not only for India, for each and every country. If the people or any person, if they are not digitalized, it means you are totally illiterate. And in coming days, you will not be able to do your any day-to-day activity. You take one example. Along with launching this Digital India campaign by our Prime Minister, he is very visionary type of the Prime Minister. He has won so many, you can say, the work or task at the same time. The latest development, it is the, you can say, the GST, introduction of GST bill. It has been passed. Now, if GST is going to be implemented in India, which is, of course, it has been implemented in India. Now, what is going to happen? For every business activity, now no manual interference will be there. Okay. Whatever bill you have to generate, it should be digital. If you want to transport your goods, your material from one city to another city, digital way will be raised. There will be no use of pen and paper. Whatever detail based on month over month, quarterly or yearly, whatever business activity detail, information, taxing, taxation, all these things you have to do, you have to develop it into, you have to transform it into digital form. The next example, take the example of banking. Earlier, in field of banking, everyone was visiting to the branch and putting there, you can say, the check and taking the cash and all these things. Now, banking sector, it is also going to revolutionized totally. Now they are also on digital platform. So many private companies has emerged. Likewise, Paytm. It is one of the just after GST and introduction of all these bills. Paytm, it was a very small company, but after digitalization, it has become very more. Its turnover has become more than 30,000 crore rupees in Indian rupees. Now everybody, if they have to pay any kind of bill, any kind of payment, electricity bill or any kind of. So they are just using their mobile phone or internet banking. Everybody is using and they are paying. So entire banking, entire, you can say, that transaction of your money, it is going to be transformed. It is going to be happen only and only in digital form. Government is still little bit liberal for transactions and all these things, but sooner or later it all will be transformed into the digital way. You can imagine how India, not only India, all developing countries or any country, how they are going to transform into digital platform. And there is the reason. The reason is that if you are going to use digital platform, your saving of time. Time, it is very important. Saving of time is there. Cost, it is also, you can say, it is very much cost effective, very speedy way for execution of all kind of work. So these are the benefit for ultimate consumer, for institutions, for organizations, for governments. Anybody can search any kind of information from digital diary or from his digital diary or from digital locker or from internet if you have made any kind of account. So these are the basic reason why everybody is going to become digitalized. Digitalized. Why Indian, you can say, the citizens, they are going to accept it? Because of they are having the thirst for digitalization. And this country can move forward because of we need the speed and speed value addition of speed on term in terms for example business. You want due to digitalization in one day we are more and more productive. We can do more and more business activity in one day. And in manual way, if we were doing, it was taking more and more time. So our productivity rate is going to increase. These are the reason. That's why this is the answer of your question. Whatever Mr. Modi, our Prime Minister, has a vision. India really, the person of India, consumer of India, they are having a very great hunger for the digitalization for digital services. Now, next. No, actually, if you are a student and if you want to make your career, of course, India, it is one of the very potential market. Whether you are working, if you want to work as a full-time employee in any company, or you can say if you want to provide your consulting services to any Indian firm or any Indian potential consumer. So India will be one of the, you can say, India should be one of important, you can say, the destination for any kind of the professionals across the world. I am going to tell you some of the facts. Most of the digital services, call center, all these things of European country, it is going to be operated on offshores here from India. So many big MNCs, in particular in service sector, they have developed their branches, or they have handed over their entire business, their entire day-to-day activity to be managed by Indian company and Indian professionals. Along with that, in same way, Indian professionals, especially in terms of software development and all these things, they are working within India, and most of them, they are also providing their services outside India, whether it is European company or USA. And there are two kind of, you can say two kind of professionals are there. One, it is the visiting professional. Visiting professional means companies having any kind of professional on their, you can say, the payroll. On demand, they are visiting in any country to any company to provide their services for a few days, 1 week, 2 weeks, 1 month, 3 months. And some of the professionals, as they are directly hired by the foreign MNC, foreign company, they are living there and they are working. Same may be option for you. If you want to make your career, Bangalore, it is the hub for all these things. See, what are the hub in India? Bangalore, this is one city. Okay. Second, it is, you can say, in Mumbai, nearby Navi Mumbai, it is there, and Pune, it is there. In Delhi, which is the capital of India, nearby one city is there, Gurgaon. It is also the hub for, you can say, all these software, you can say, the software business, digital marketing, all these things. For individual, you can say, the student, likewise, you, I can suggest that if you are coming here in India, you will get at par. If you are hired by any good company, likewise Infosys, Wipro, Tata Consultancy, their services and facilities to you or any foreign foreign employee, it is at par with the USA company. There will not be any kind of discrimination. Sometime if you visit to Bangalore, you will find so many foreigners from USA and so many other countries, they are living, and even they are enjoying Indian culture. Their dress material, it is totally Indian, likewise female. They are wearing saris, they are meeting with the Indian families, and they are enjoying very good, you can say, the type of salary, services, everything, whatever you can avail it in your country or in USA or in Europe. If you are having a quality talent, you can avail here. And based on that, very bright chances are there. Because of, take example, if you are working in Tata Consulting or Infosys, all these partners, all these Indian companies, you are having very bright chances that company will definitely send you into different international market on different projects. Very bright chances are there. Because of most of the time, people or employees, they are shifting from here. Project is coming, then a team will be developed, and that team will be shifted to USA, London, or whatever, based on actual location of providing the job. So we are having equal very good opportunity, and India, it is going to emerge as one of the biggest, you can say, the market, whether it is digital system market, digitalization, due to digitalization, all these things. You can think that you should make your career in India or Indian company, or even you can join. I hope that in Italy, USA, so many Indian company or their branches are operating. You can join there also, and you can come here. If you are coming to India, it will be also beneficial that you will get very good type of the exposure in your work area, because of India in itself, very diverse type of the market is there. So different kind of the problem and challenges you will face during your project. And whatever problem and challenges you are facing, you are developing a skill. If you are not having any challenge or problem, it means there is no scope for development. So to develop your professional skill, India is also a very good and potential prospective workplace also. See, the basic thing, whether it is India or any other thing, one fundamental factor working that whether you will get a contract, whether you will be able to get clients in India or not. I would like to assure you, there is no need to develop any kind of fear factor that if, since you are from foreign country, you will not get client, or India consumer, they will not entertain you. I would like to tell you, in India, most of the business persons or most of the person, they are bilingual, bi, not only bi but trilingual. Here are concept of three languages: one, regional language or local language; second, you can say, the Hindi; and third, it is the English. Everyone can understand English. Likewise, you are not facing any kind of problem in terms of communicating with me. You will not face any kind of problem in communication. This is one thing. Everywhere you will be entertained. Second important thing, the dealing, it is very much fair and competitive and in professional way. For example, if you are giving your quotation or detail of your services to any potential consumer, if you are suitable according to his parameter, 101% you will get a client, you will get a business. Don't think that there will be any kind of discrimination that you are from that country, you are from this country. Not a kind of discrimination it is there. So many MNCs are working here, so many employees from MNCs. You will be taken care in very well manner by Indian people as well as your Indian colleague. So do not need. Whether, yes, I am going to tell you, whether it is a small area, rural area or metropolitan city, everywhere you will get same kind of the treatment, means welcome by open arms, whether it is your client or whether it is any common person. If you go to any rural area, you will enjoy that rural area. People socially, they will welcome to you and they will ask about yourself, that what is your name, from which country you have come, they will welcome. So don't be frightened for anything. Now I am coming to your professional question. The professional answer for your question is that freelancers are there. So how to compete with the freelancers? We should try to understand the nature of freelancers, what kind of services and how they are providing. So you should understand only one basic fundamental, you can say, difference will be there. If any big company is there, their charges or their prices will be high, okay, for the same services. Freelancers, they will be providing services on cheaper cost. So there are two dimensions, quality of service and cost of delivery. If you can compete on these two parameters, there is no question for being frightened. You will be welcomed everywhere. And this is universal law for any country. No, see, actually, how client is going to select any kind of service provider? The first thing, that the service provider should be enough capable to deliver the services on two norms. That is the quality. For example, if any big company or government organization is there and you are a small freelancer, so you will not be able to handle that kind of the client because of the workload as well as the quality of work, whatever it is required, definitely a small layer may not be having that kind of the digital infrastructure to satisfy the need or you can say the demand of that client. But of course, if you are a small player, if you are a freelancer, then your client class will be totally different. And you can say tremendous, there is no lack of, you can say, the business opportunity. Don't think about big client, because see, for example, government, if you want to take the government organization or big companies, they are having very specific and legal procedure. Open bidding will be there and you have to declare that what are your expertise, since how many years you are running your company, your past experience, in detail, everything. So you have to qualify all those parameters, then and then you can qualify for that tender or job or work. But not to worry, so many small clients are there. They will be definitely they will be readily available to take your services. You try to interact with all these, you can say, the segment or you can say the class of consumers, those who are really suitable for you or as per, you can say, the infrastructure as well as the available services which your company is going to provide. So deciding which is your customer class or consumer class, this is most important task here. If you are a small company and you are coming and you are thinking that directly you will get the very big type of the pan-India level project by government of India, it will not be possible because of you are not qualifying for that. You cannot qualify the norms, rules and regulations. So you can go for the medium size of the companies. Tremendous opportunities are there and they are also going to pay you very well. A small, medium type of the company or firm, even individual, they are paying you very well, not to worry for that. I am going to tell you, after when Mr. Narendra Modi has been elected as our Prime Minister, so many changes are going to be happen here, especially if any company from foreign country want to enter into Indian market, whether it is digital services or any manufacturing industry, everything is going to become very much easy. in past, of course, it may be taking 2 months, 3 months to getting introduced in India, government paperwork, so many formalities you had to complete. Same it is applicable for yourself. Right now there is no hesitation, no hurdle. Okay, what you have to do, you just have to select only a good CA, chartered accountant. Okay, so many CAs are there. You have to hire, you have to contact a related professional, related person for registration of company. I am noticing all these things within 15 days to maximum of 29 days, every activity to maximum of, you can say, 15 to 30 days. No matter, you are sitting there, you sit at your country, whatever it is required, documentation, all these things it is required, you just hand over all those documentation and information, your company will be registered here. Okay, so taxation coming on, once you entered into, you can say, the Indian market, your firm has been legally created. Now day-to-day activity and taxation. Taxation, it is not a problem. No manipulation may be possible because of entire taxation, as I told, after GST, introduction of GST, goods and services tax. Everything has been brought, you can say, on digital platform. No manual work is there. Automatic calculation will be there, and automatically you just have to automatically report will go to the government that, yeah, for this month, for this quarter, for this year, yeah, these were the transactions, these are the taxations. So there is no hurdle. Taxation, it is always supporting for any kind of entrepreneurs, especially it is from foreign company, any person from foreign or any person from India. So all these are making more and easier of doing business. All these new rules and regulation is going to help you to make you can say your day-to-day activity more easy. So not to worry for all these things. Everything is going to become very much cheap and easier and fast. Right. No, actually, see, I am also a portal consultant, so I can assure you why India should be a preferred destination for you, especially from foreign. 3-4 definitely character it is there. First, you see the in historic perspective, our culture, historical culture. See, from, you can say, last 5000 year, you can say, documented history, it is available, and we are very welcoming for any foreigner. Whether you are from any country, we are very Indian people, they are very much welcoming. One statement, one quotation is there, Atithi Devo Bhav, means guest are God. This is a common mentality, common thinking, social behavior, that guest or foreign person, we are treating them as a God. This is one thing. Now, political conditions, see, very fair judiciary is there, very strong judiciary is there, as well as very strong supporting government. As of today, it is very there for business community, whether you are from foreign or whether you are from Indian. So whatever political, you can say, the environment, it is there. Of course, after 5 year elections will be there, but being a consultant, you are into consulting business, there will not be any kind of the problem. You don't worry for any kind of problem here, it will come. Doing business in India, it is as easy as it is easy in Italy or in your hometown or anywhere. You will not find any kind of difference. Only the condition is that if you are speaking English, that's all. Whatever English you are speaking, it is enough. No, nothing else it is required. Nothing, another quality it is required for you. No matter whether government is going to change after next election or not, the impact on business persons, business professionals, consultants will not be there. There will be the zero impact. Your business will be running. You will be enjoying your, you can say, the growth of your business. So don't bother for all these political and social culture. It will not be affecting. If it will be affecting, it will be affecting you in a positive mood. No. I am going to tell you different kind of political ideology is available. You are from Italy. One of the top leader from Congress, Mrs. Sonia Gandhi. She is also from your country. You know, Mrs. Sonia Gandhi, you search on Google, Mrs. Sonia Gandhi, she is heading Congress. Congress, it is one of the leading political party. Approximately 60 to 70 years, they formed government in India, and it was headed by Mrs. Sonia Gandhi. And second, currently the head of this Congress party, Mr. Rahul Gandhi. Mr. Rahul Gandhi mother, he is from Italy. So you can't think that nothing, whether it is left, right, no matter whatever government it is coming, whether left government ideology is coming or right side type of the ideology is coming or any other political party is coming, day-to-day activity and business activity, it is untouched, it is undisturbed, nothing. Right. 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 Thank you. Sure, sure. No, see, no matter whatever your caste is there, no matter whatever your gender is there, no matter whatever your citizenship is there, whether you are from any country or any state. India in itself is having, I told you, very diversified type of the country. But you do not need to worry about caste, gender and all these things, discrimination. Whether it is male, female, you are from any caste, or your client, you take example, what will happen if you will come to India? Your one client is from different caste and another client will be different caste. If you go in Uttar Pradesh, the language medium of communication may be different, Hindi. But if you go to Maharashtra, your communication medium, again, a different language and culture will be there. There will be a Marathi. If you go in South India, four different kind of the culture and language you will find. Different kind of the ethnicity will be there. But along with all these ethnic diversification, what is the strongest thing? That we all are Indian and our common philosophy, especially for foreigners, it is same, that guest is God. You go any part of India, our basic backbone philosophy, common philosophy, it is same. Right. No, I am going to tell you, in every 5 year elections used to happen in India. So there is always the chances that this government is this time, next time any other government is may be there. Yeah, for elections it is a 5 year tenure. If you are thinking that this government, during the period of this government rules are different, during next government rules may be changed. Of course, little bit it is there, but it will not be hampering because of whatever change will be there, it will be analyzed, and if any kind of change is going to be happen, then definitely 101% it will be for beneficial for the future. It will be a value addition. No government would like to do that, since we have formed our government, so whatever existing business is there, we should try to crash. So no government will deploy any kind of rules and regulation which is going to hamper current business setup and all these things. If any kind of change is there, it will be always to improve your productivity more and more, to make your day-to-day activity more easy, doing business should be more and more easy. Change will be always in positive. That is a different phenomenon. Of course, in our constitution, there is the provision of general election after every 5 years, and it used to happen, whether it is USA or any other thing. But the prime focus of any government is there, not to hamper business, not to hamper our people, not to hamper the foreigner. Value addition will be there. So don't think that if any new government, whether it is left, right or any ideology, if they are coming, then they will say Tata goodbye to all the foreigners. It is not possible. Thank you. Sure, sure. Yeah. Sure, sure, sure. Sure, sure. Welcome, welcome. Anytime. Sure. Anytime you can contact to me or any Indian, you will find same kind of the, you can say the nature every time it is welcoming. So once again, I would like to conclude whatever doubt, because of, see, you may be thousands of kilometers away from here. You may be thinking that what will be there. See, there is one concept, it is there. When two, you can say totally stranger type of the people or communities get, you can say, come closer, little bit time it takes to become very much familiar. But I think I can assure you, so many foreigners they are coming, and as I am perfect doing business in India, it will not take time to establish your business in India because of so many across the world Indians are going to different countries, and different countries peoples they are coming to India. So it is doing business in India, you will 101% feel that you are doing business in Milan or in any other city of Italy. It will be the same. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Bye.